Hi people, welcome to my channel. My name is Victor and thanks for joining me today. I really do appreciate and I do not take it for granted. If it's your first time, please kindly hit on the notification bell so you get notified whenever I post a new video. But please don't forget to subscribe and share my video to your loved ones. Let's go into the video right away and talking about worship beyond your lips, worship beyond instrument, and worship beyond religion, you know. God again is noting to us, is bringing to our attention that there is something very important when it comes to worshiping Him. There is something that He wants, there is something that He doesn't want to skip, that there is something He wants to be constant there when it comes to worshiping Him. So it's okay to worship God by our instrument, it's okay to worship God by our lips, it's okay to cry while we worship God. It's okay to worship God, you know, by what we can and by what we have. It's okay. But then again, God is noting one important thing, that is worship itself. And we search in the scripture again, we see the word of God in the book of John saying that the hour cometh and now is that the true worshipers, we worship the Father in truth and in spirit. And Jesus said, for the Father seeketh. So this is Jesus, the Son of God, talking to us, saying that worship is no longer by all means, but by this means. So you see, there are two different things there. It's no longer by all means, but by this means. That is Jesus talking, saying to us that it is only in truth and in spirit that the Father is pleased by our worship. And again, we have seen so many people explain this part of the scripture to us, tell us that it is, you know, when you're speaking in tongue, that is in truth and that is in spirit. Well, it's okay to speak in tongue, and that's a proof that Jesus is alive. That's a proof that the promise of the Spirit has been fulfilled. That's a proof that Jesus has risen. That's a proof that He is sitting at the right hand of the Father. That's a proof that the churches are strengthened day by day by the Spirit of God. That's a proof. And it helps us also to know that we are strong. You know, when we speak in tongues, the Bible says we are energized. So it's to our benefit also when we speak in tongues, when we are afraid of circumstances, we are afraid of situations, we are afraid of things that will come to us. You know, we speak in tongues. And 1 hour, 2 hours, 30 minutes, 15 minutes, and we are strengthening our inner mind. And then we can face our situation, we can face and stare at our circumstances and all of that. So speaking in tongues is very vital and very important. God has chosen the foolish things of this world, you know, to make the wise useless, to make the things of the wise, you know, nothing. So that is God in His greatness, in His omnipotent, So that's God for us, and we have seen this. So what is it about worshiping God in truth and in spirit that God really wants us to do? What is it about worshiping in truth and in spirit? Is it that when we speak in tongue? Maybe not exactly. No, not exactly. But what God is saying to us, Jesus is saying to us, is that we must worship the Father in truth and in spirit. In truth and in spirit. You hear the word of God saying, you worship me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. Again, that is what God is saying when He says, you must worship me in truth and in spirit. What does it mean? It must be by your heart. It must be that your heart is not far from God. It must be that your heart is close to God. So that is what it means to worship God in truth and in spirit. It must be that we are close to our Father. We are close to Him. So that's why we need to understand that Christianity is a relationship. Once you are far, once you are no longer close, you know, God might be, God is now dwelling in us. Once we no longer see God there in us, once that relationship is broken, we are far from God. And that is just the main important thing there to note. You see, God wants us to understand that we are in a relationship. Yes, we are in a relationship right now, assistance to, you know, relationship with our Creator, relationship with our Maker, relationship with our God and our Father. We are in a relationship. And God is saying that, oh, to worship me, you must worship me in truth, and it must be in the spirit. And again, we are noting that to worship God in truth and in spirit must mean that we are close to Him. We are close to Him. It must mean that we are not far, our heart particularly, it's not far from Him. So when you see the word of God saying, you worship me with your heart. Sorry, you worship me with your lips, but your heart is far away from me. Again, we are still breaking down on this, guys. So again, what is he saying? He's saying your heart is far from me. And again, we want to know what makes someone's heart to be far from God. What makes someone to be away from God's presence, to be far from God. You know, when you are in the presence of God, and we mean presence, and I don't mean a four-corner house or a building. No, that's not what I mean. I mean when you are in God's presence, like God is in you and you are in Him. God's presence. So when we are in the presence of God, we are not far from Him. We recall with the story of Adam and Eve, when the Bible says that they are always communing with God at the cool of the day. At the cool of the day, Adam always commune with God at the cool of the day, and he's always in the presence of God. And what happened? He fell from power. He fell from authority. He fell, you know, from that life that God has given to him. So, what does God noted to us when He said, "Your heart is far from me"? Just one thing. He's saying, you are no longer in my presence. You no longer do what I ask you to do. So when Adam and Eve fell and disobeyed God, what happened? God chased them away from the Garden of Eden. He chased them away. And that came about the distance. So when you see Jesus coming to us, He came to us so He can bring us together with God. So man fell from God and there was distance. So man could not communicate with God. Our heart was far from God now. We are very far from God. So when Jesus said, yeah, our commandment now is not a true worshiper. We worship the Father in truth and in spirit. Jesus is saying, oh, you must learn to obey God. Obedience is true worship. Obedience is true worship. Obedience is a worship that God accepts. So it's okay to worship by our lips. It's okay to worship by the instrument. It's okay to worship. But the true worship is in obedience. You see, the word of God saying, obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience before prayer. Obedience before singing. Obedience before giving. Obedience before helping. Obedience before loving. I mean, self-love. No, loving you, your own type of love. I mean, obedience before that. Obedience before any other thing. Why? Why obedience? Because disobedience is the only thing that separates you. Disobedience is the only thing that takes you away from the presence. Disobedience is the only thing that makes you not to worship in truth and in spirit. There's a reason why God provided forgiveness, that people should be forgiven. As far as God is concerned, sin is forever an enemy to God. Sin is forever an enemy. And so, obey God and damn the consequences. True worship is in obedience. True worship is in obedience. And we must learn to worship God in truth and in spirit. To worship God in truth and in spirit, it must be by our heart. And what is it about our heart that we are close to God? We don't have issues. When we are in a relationship, if I'm in a relationship with you, and we are in good terms, we communicate every time. We are good all time. Everything is good. But the moment we have issues, oh no, there's distance between us. Sometimes we stay 2 days, 3 days, and we don't talk. So that's what God is talking about, that heart. A heart that obeys is a heart that is always with God. It's a heart that is always coming back to God. And I pray that God will help our mind and our understanding at this point, that obedience is true worship. It's a worship that is beyond the lips. It is worship of the heart that is obedient. Worship of the heart. That our heart has been transplanted. That our heart is again conformed already to the obedience and to the doing of the Father's way. That is it. And I pray that God will help our mind and help our understanding. So thank you guys for joining me again. It's been a wonderful time with you guys. And I really enjoy every bit of it. I hope that you enjoyed it too. And please share this video to your loved one. I want people to know this and understand, you know, how they can apply this thing in their life. And by God's grace, that we take the grace of God as a power and as a strength that will help us in all of these things. It's not easy, but we believe by the Spirit of God, all things are possible. All things. All things. You know, the scripture said that when the Spirit comes down from on high into the wilderness. So with the wilderness, we become a fruitful ground. The dry ground will become a fruitful ground. That's important for us to note. And thank you again for joining. I do appreciate you. I appreciate it. And do have a wonderful day. Peace out, guys.